Hi, world. Not as beautiful as a day as it was yesterday, but, you know, still get some sunlight in here and stuff like that. Got my smart glasses on. So, we're still trapped inside. We look like we're trapped inside for a while. I found American Gladiators on TV, and I've been watching some old reruns of that half the morning. And so, when I was thumbing, when I was getting dressed this morning, I was trying to figure out what shirt to wear. I got my old Hulkamania shirt on. I got this shirt 6 years ago. 6 years ago when WrestleMania 30 was in New Orleans before I moved out of Mississippi. And then me and my family, we went to WrestleMania 30. One of the highlights of my life, you know, got to see Hulk Hogan. Oh, yeah. And I realized I have a lot of wrestling shirts in my closet. Macho Man, Roddy Piper, NWO Wolfpack for life. And I got three Hulk Hogan shirts. Three! And two of them I bought this year. So I bought two of them this year in Orlando when I went to Hulk Hogan's shop in Orlando. So I looked into that, and I know my last video was all me acting all goofy because, you know, I was finally outside, even though I was waiting through drive-thru at a CVS. But, you know, one thing Hulk Hogan used to always say is he used to get his hand and point at the palm and said, "This is the where the power of Hulkamania lies. This is the power where Hulkamania lies." And he talked about saying your prayers and taking your vitamins and working out and all that. So that was his shtick. That was his thing. He would always talk about this. Every interview was almost to a key. Every other word was brother. And he would talk about prayers, training, taking your vitamins, power of Hulkamania. And he would talk about when he would take big men and slam them down like Earthquake and Andre the Giant and all this. So Christian just posted a video not too long ago, about, you know, these times are crazy and about patience. This one's about prayer. Psalms 102, verse 17 says, "He will pray. He, God, will pay attention to the prayers of the destitute and will not despise their prayers." So, I teach my students a lot about translations of the Bible and how some words, they may be like, "Wow, man, that's a little intense. That's a little heavy," or you know, some of them may not be as much. Well, you know, the first word I pick out here is destitute, and good old Google, and the translator on it, I looked it up because, you know, it means without basic necessities of life. Well, most of my Mississippi friends and Louisiana friends, we lived through Katrina. We lived through Hurricane Katrina. And I told my wife, I said, "Man, it's like living during Katrina. We couldn't go anywhere. Except we can go to the grocery store. We can go get gas. We have cable TV, hot water." And the word destitute means without basic necessities of life. Guys, we should praise God that we still have those basic necessities of life. Because as it says, he will pay attention to the prayers of the destitute. Guys, like it or not, we're not America, we're not destitute. I mean, we still got nice homes, we still got good places to stay. We're still able to go to the grocery store so far. We're still able to go get our gas. A lot of us are still able to work online now or work from home or have jobs where they have to go to work. We're not. But God will pay attention to those prayers who are destitute. The people who are destitute. Even them. So just think about that. I've said this before, we should spend more time in prayer. And the last part of verse 17 says, he will not despise his prayers. God will not despise their prayers. despise their prayers. Again, handy Google translator. Despise. Feeling contempt or a deep repugnance for. Repugnance for. Yeah, I shaved. Yes, ma'am, I shaved. I was getting tired of it. That's my sister telling me I shaved. Yes, I shaved. But feeling contempt and a deep repugnance for. And so I looked up the word repugnance. You know. Intense disgust is what it means. So now we know kind of the words meaning. I'm using the SCSB, HCSB, excuse me. He will pay attention to the prayers of the destitute and will not despise their prayers. Guys, hey, we got to think about, we're okay right now. We're doing fine. Yeah, we're probably going crazy in our homes. I know I am. You see, I got my smart glasses on because, you know, I ain't going outside today. But according to this, if he's going to listen to people who, of course you do, Eric. One of my Mississippi friends says, I love the Mississippi translations pronunciation. Yeah. he said if he'll pay attention to the prayers of the destitute and will not despise their prayers, he will definitely listen to us. That's a good thing. So, hey, those of y'all who are involved in my student ministry or any other student ministry, we're gonna do a Zoom Bible study Thursday at 6. I got a practice meeting today at 3 to see if you can work Zoom or whatever you want to do with it. I know it had a couple students tried it out yesterday. So I got a meeting today, practice meeting today at 3, a practice meeting tomorrow at 3, then the Bible study for 6th through 12th grade at 6 on Zoom. So y'all take it easy, guys. Watch Christian's video. It's on his little Facebook thing. So y'all take care. Stay inside as much as you can, even though if it kills you or it feels like it's going to kill you. And remember, Hulkamania. Say your prayers, take your vitamins, and train. Yeah, that's what he always said.